All right, well, 10cc provided the soundtrack for a generation in the 70s. The British band recorded hit after hit after hit, and fans will have the chance to relive the band's success when 10cc tour the country. Have a look. And I say I don't like reggae. Love that song. Please welcome 10cc founding member and singer Graham Gouldman to Studio 10.
Hello.
Hey, welcome. Now, you had a hit with your very first songwriting attempt for Your Love for the Yardbirds. Yeah. Surely it can't be that easy to write a hit.
Well, you never know when you're writing a hit. That's the interesting thing. You just write what you want to write at the time and all being well, you know, other people will like it and it will do well.
And the Herman's Hermits manager paid you to write songs. Is it hard to give songs to another artist? Because, you know, you can't win, can you? If it's good, you want to keep it for yourself. If it's, you don't think it's good, then they're going to fail with it.
Well, when I first started writing in the mid-60s, that's all I was doing. I was just writing songs and you know, giving them to other people, and I was very happy to do that. But, of course, when we formed 10cc in 1972, that was really a dream come true for me and the rest of the members of the band, because we were all writing, we were producing, we were performing, and we had our own studio as well. It was great.
There's nothing like it.
With Lennon and McCartney, one wrote the lyrics and the other the music. How do you approach a song?
Well, all of us in the original band, we all wrote music and lyrics. So sometimes someone would take a lead on a song and the other would kind of become an editor for him. But everybody did everything, really. And to approach a song so many different ways. I mean, Dreadlock Holiday is a good example of an idea that I got when I was having a conversation with somebody about sports. I was talking about Manchester United and I said, what about you? What about cricket? Do you like cricket? And he was a Jamaican guy. And he said, no, I don't like it. I said, oh, I'm surprised. He said, no, I love it. So he kind of gave me the line.
Oh, and and it was such a great line too.
Now, it's brilliant.
Oh, it's wonderful. 10cc, they were massive in Britain and Australia, but it took some time to crack the US market, didn't it? Until the song I'm Not In Love. Now, that must have been pretty satisfying to do it in the US.
Very, very satisfying indeed, yeah. Our first big hit and in America, and we followed it with The Things We Do For Love as well. That did very well.
The things we do for love.
That song, actually, that's right. I remember as a kid so much. But the thing that stood out for me, and I want to know who actually was responsible for that bit, because whenever my brother used to be sooking when we were little, I used to turn to him and go, "Big boys don't cry. Big boys don't cry." who did that bit?
Yeah, it was actually a girl called Kathy who was the secretary in our recording studio. And it was Lowell's idea. He said, we need a girl's voice to say these words. And she came in. It took her about two takes to do it. And then she went back to the typing. But she did get a gold disc for her trouble.
Oh, not bad for a receptionist.
Yeah.
And, of course, just like the Blues Brothers, you've got the band back together. You're playing all the hits with these shows coming up. And is there one song in particular that the fans really just go ape over?
Well, I think we're lucky in that we've had so many hits, but I guess really the two songs that people recognise, you know, as soon as we start are I'm Not In Love and Dreadlock Holiday.
Yeah. I'm not in love.
It's been stuck in our head all morning. Hey, Graham, thanks so much for joining us. We do appreciate it. And all
pleasure.
The dates and where you can see 10cc are on our website.